Artist Josh Simpson first made glass in 1971 while spending a winter semester at Goddard College. That year, he rented land in northern Vermont, lived in a teepee, and built a tiny glass working studio out of old barn beams. Now in his seventh decade of life, the Shelburne Falls resident is today considered by many to be one of the best glass blowers in the world. Producer Dave Fraser visited with Simpson as he reflected back on his amazing career.
When I started to blow glass, I never for a moment considered it as a potential career. It was just the most fun, exciting thing that I could possibly do at the time.
For half a century, Josh Simpson has been creating art objects from glass. His studio is this big red barn just off the Mohawk Trail in Shelburne Falls.
I think that all the work that I do is in some way related to space, whether planets that I make give you an idea of what it's like to be an astronaut orbiting around a small little world, but I also make pieces that I call tektites that have use the same formula of glass as meteorites that have fallen to Earth from outer space. I also make plates that are what I feel are my idea of what it's like to look up at the sky on a perfect summer night.
The process starts with a small, red-hot, malleable mass of liquid on the end of a blowpipe. Fighting gravity with every turn, Simpson stops only to reheat and then rework the piece until he's satisfied with the outcome.
Glass is insanely hot. You can never touch it. It is one material that, as an artist, I can never, ever touch it with my hands. The result would be horrific. And so my job is to create something and get that liquid to cooperate. That's part of the challenge. That's part of what makes it fun, is the fact that you need to get as close as you possibly can to this dangerous liquid.
That's good.
Ideally without burning yourself, but or close enough to feel the heat.
In 1976, Simpson started making glass planets, complete with oceans, continents, volcanoes, and clouds. Some of them have literally left this Earth into outer space, traveling with his wife, astronaut Catherine Katie Coleman, who lived on the International Space Station for several months in 2011.
The way he looks at this, at the piece, the way he just is so sure that if he wants it to be a certain way, he can just do that. It's in a way, it's like the space program, where people say, well, when are we gonna get to Mars? Well, we're gonna go when we're ready, and it's a long journey, and it's a lot of actually small steps. I see that in his work as well, where something that he's been thinking about, 40 years ago, a kind of combination of glass, and then with what he's then been learning, I'll see him kind of go back to that and go, wow, that thing that I couldn't do back then, now I've got a way to do that.
Josh and Katie married in 1997, and one would think that marrying an astronaut was the reason for the creation of the planets. But according to Josh, that's not the case.
I was making planets long before I met my wife. It is amazing to me that Katie joined NASA in 1992, and she has gotten to explore the world the way I imagine exploring the world. I make these glass spheres, and I think about flying around those, whether it's an underwater scene or whether I feel like I'm an astronaut flying in orbit around one.
Many of the planets Simpson's made have been planted on mountaintops, hidden in forests, and buried at sea all over the world as part of his Infinity Project. He estimates that at least 3,000 globes have been hidden in diverse places around the world.
When I moved here 40 years ago, no one was collecting my glass. And I thought, I should make little spheres and hide them around the world, not with my name on them, but I should just hide them. And maybe someday they'll be found by a random stranger or by a kid. And it's kind of a present to give to somebody in the future.
Since learning glassblowing in the early 1970s, Simpson has made thousands of planets, as well as tremendous glass platters, goblets, and bowls. The largest planets are a foot in diameter and weigh 50 pounds or more.
I feel so fortunate that the pieces that I like to make and the work and the concepts that I like to explore in glass seem to be things that people like to collect. And I've just been incredibly lucky that people understand what I'm doing and want to share in that.